Hi there! Welcome to my channel! Are you looking for more interactive games for your virtual classroom? Wait no more! For in this second part of our interactive games video tutorial, you will learn two more games that you can create in Google Slides. Like you, I also believe that game-based learning plays an important role in teaching by making students to collaborate, communicate, interact, and work in teams. More than that, do you know that strategic games improve the functioning of the brain? Gaming creates a dynamic that can inspire learners to develop skills and build an emotional connection to learning and subject matter. So let's go and get started, for I cannot wait to share you these interactive games. But before we begin, if you are new in my channel, please click the like and subscribe button below. Also, if you like this video, give us your comments and ideas below and share this video to your teacher friends. And if you want a copy of the game templates I made, fill out the Google Forms link in the description below. The first game I will share to you is one of the most popular games of all time. According to Wiki, the earliest mention of this game is from the Song Dynasty in early Chinese civilization. Modern ones first appeared in Italy during the 18th century, but how it developed into the modern game is unknown. There's speculations that Italian missionaries in China may have brought the game to Europe. I'm sure some of you have an idea already what game I'm talking about. Yes, you got it right! Dominoes. Like the usual dominoes game rule, you begin by shuffling the domino cards, but instead of placing them down, you just keep them facing up. That's a whole lot of tutorial if we decided to do that. Then, pair up students. Each student alternately grab one start domino and one end domino, and then split all of the remaining dominoes equally. Rock, paper, scissors to know who will start. By the way, for this example, I use stages of mitosis and some vocabulary words, which is a biology lesson. What topic in your subject area do you think you can use dominoes? I'm sure you have a lot of ideas. Back to the game rule. So each player then lay their domino cards end to end and making sure that joining ends are matching. Meaning that, say in this example, the stages of mitosis is matching with the description of the event. The last player to place a domino card with a correct match wins the game. Another variation is to have students play this individually and have them just connect all of the domino cards, minus two, by joining the matching sides until all 10 are exhausted. Or why not add spice to it and let them play this in a small group of 2, 3, or 4, and so there's an element of competition. You basically provide each group a copy of the domino Google slides, and the first team to finish connecting all 10 domino cards correctly wins the game. Whatever your preference, feel free to modify the rules in the domino cards and share your ideas in the comment section below. Have fun playing dominoes with your students! Are you ready for another game? Our next game will take you and your students to another level. The game is called Who Done It, a mystery crime game. The game starts with a scenario, then there's the pieces of evidence that includes the list of suspects, the last known whereabouts of the suspects, and the method used for the crime. For face-to-face game, you give the students a printed copy of the Who Done It slides, don't include the answer key, and the answer sheet slide. Then, the students will need to answer 10 genetics multiple choice questions, which if answered correctly will result in a clue. This game is not limited to biology or to science. Actually, I think this is more fun for math subjects. Can you think of a topic? Back to the game. Students will check up the players, last known whereabouts locations, and methods that are accounted for. The one remaining from each column is the correct solution. Print out the clues, cut them out, and laminate them for future use. Spread them in different locations in the classroom and turn them loose. I'm sure the students will love it. Have 3 to 4 teams of students circulating and attempting to figure out the clues. Once they think they have all the pieces, they can come to you to see if their answers or clues are correct. For a virtual version of the game, share the whodunit slides to all students, and again, don't include the answer key. Provide students with an electronic copy of the whodunit slides 3-column table so they can use it to check up clues. Project the whodunit slide three-column table as you explain the instructions, and then let the students answer the 10-order genetics multiple-choice questions in no particular order. Students will check up the players, last known whereabouts locations, and methods that are accounted for until they arrive to one solution. One last thing, and as always, before we finish up, make sure to teach your students first the basic tools in Google Slides like an undo button and basic skills like resizing, moving, and rotating images before doing any of these games. Also, you may want to make several copies of your interactive games Google Slides if you are teaching multiple classes. That's it for this tutorial. Have fun in playing these games with your students, and don't forget to leave me your comments. Like and subscribe to my channel so you're updated of new videos. That's it for now. I will see you next time.